everyone, and a very warm welcome to WS Cube Tech. So guys, in a previous session, we have covered that how to scroll a page using WebDriver using Selenium. In our today's session, we will be learning that what is wait times in Selenium. So let's have a look on what is wait times. So guys, there are two methods in which we can use wait times. Now, what is wait times? Let's understand that. Let's say I'll write any website's name over here. For example, if I'll write Twitter, I'll open Twitter. Now you will notice that it's taking around 2 to 3 seconds to load the whole page for me, right? So this is wait times, guys, that whenever you're writing a code and in between your page is taking a little time to load, you need to provide your code with a little wait time so that your code can stop for a while and then it can execute the next line. This is what wait time is. And in Selenium, there are two methods, there are two ways in which we can use this wait time and make our code stop. The first method, as we have seen previously in our previous videos as well, that was time.sleep. Just copy the link of this web page, go back to my code, use over here that driver.get, and in here I'll pass this link. Also, you will notice that I have already imported time over here. And now I will, suppose I'll go back here and I want to click on anything. Okay, so let me just open it in my Chrome driver. And as soon as I'll run it, it will open the driver for me, taking a little time to load. Okay, now suppose if I want to do anything, let's say I want to inspect this search Twitter and I want to open, let's say, anything here. So in that case, I'll right click on it, inspect it, go over here. And you will find the input tag related to our search box. So let's right click on it, copy its full path, and I'll paste it here. Like, as I'm creating a variable over here, that search is equals to driver dot find element by x path. And in here, I'll pass the x path. And what do I need to do over here is I need to maybe search anything. So anything that is trending. Okay, so maybe I'll search for Elon Musk here. And I'll write search dot send keys, and here I'll pass Elon Musk and click on the enter button, or you can just click on anything. So if I'll go back here, if I write something like I'll write Elon Musk. Okay, so once we're done with this, I need to press the enter key. For the enter key, if you remember, we have this common keys which we have learned before as well. Okay, and here we will be writing search dot send keys, and which key do we need to press is capital K keys dot enter key. So we need to press the enter key here. Now let's run and see what will happen if I have not given any wait time here. So as you can see that nothing happened here, even though I have given the address of the user input, I have written some text inside it, I have pressed the enter button, but none of that happened. Why it did not happen is because our page is taking a lot of time to load. Once we are on the web page, we need to write time dot sleep for maybe 3 to 4 seconds. So I'll go with maybe 4 seconds because Twitter, again, it's a heavy web page, as it has videos, it has posts, it has photos. So it takes a little while to load. And now I'll run it again. It will wait for 4 seconds. And now something new popped up. Okay. So this time a new page popped up. I don't know why that happened, but let's run it again. Maybe this time something else will pop up, or the previous thing will pop up. So it took 4 seconds. It will wait for 4 seconds, find the element, and automatically it will search Elon Musk and press enter. So as you can see, this did not happen the previous time, but this time it happened. Why it happened was the reason that this time we have given time.sleep. We are giving enough time for the web page to load. So in order to make your code work, in order to make your whole procedure of automation work, we need to give it a wait time so that let it be the internet issue or let it be the web page only that is taking a lot of time to load. We need to give it a time so that our code doesn't stop. There is another method which I usually do not prefer because it takes a lot of time and I need to import more libraries for it. Like with the Selenium only, I need to call more functions here. So I'll just show it to you that what is the second method. For our second method, I'll just remove time.sleep over here. Now, how does the second method works is very simple. That however time it is taking over here to load, what it will do, like suppose once your page is loaded, it will search for any element over here, and until that search is not finished, it will not do the next step. For example, let me just show it to you by writing a code. So I'll be writing over here from selenium.webdriver.common.by import B by. Okay, and from Selenium. So we need, as I told you, we need to import so many things over here for this second method. So the I like the first method because all you need to do is write import time and you need to give time.sleep. The second method takes a little while. So from selenium.webdriver.support.ui, we need to import webdriver wait. Okay. And again from selenium.webdriver.support, we have to import expected conditions. And let's give it an alias called as EC. Okay, this is how this thing works. Now, what we need to do is, like, once a page has started loading, we'll give it a little while so that it can find any element on the page. To find any element on the page, the whole page needs to be loaded. So it will keep looking for any element, let's say, on the page. So for that, I'll be writing, let's say, element is equals to WebDriver. I'll write capital W, WebDriver wait. Driver, comma, 10 dot. So it has to wait until 10 seconds until it has found the expected conditions of presence of an element located. And then what we need to do, we need to provide an ID over here. So we will be looking, doing it by ID. So by, you can look for anything, like if you want to go for its name, its XPath, you can go for XPath as well. So it, what it will do basically, I'll just show it to you, and then here we will be passing our XPath. So now let's run and see. And as soon as we run it, it will open a new tab for us. The whole web page will load. It will find the element entertainment. Then go to the search box and write Elon Musk and press enter. Now, what has happened over here is, let me just explain it to you, that I'll just run it again and show it to you, that it will load the web page, it will call for that web page, and on that web page, it will wait for 10 seconds, it will wait for 10 seconds until it finds the element entertainment. As soon as it finds entertainment, it will move to our next part of code, that is, you go to input, you write Elon Musk, and you press enter there. As you can see, the second method takes a lot of time and it takes a lot of code. So I definitely do not recommend you using the second method. But yes, this is again another method by which you can do it. So both the methods are in front of you guys. You can use the time.sleep or you can use this second method for wait times, where you have to import these three things from Selenium and you have to write this set of code, where you will tell WebDriver to wait for 10 seconds until it finds the presence of the element located by the XPath and the XPath that we have given it over here. So I hope, guys, that you have no doubts in the questions and what wait times is and what is the importance of wait time. In our next session, we are going to create a small project on the website of House of the Dragon. So stay connected, guys, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.